Hi there. Today on Typical Books, it will be a wrap-up and haul for March, or as I prefer, mergers and acquisitions. So yeah, these are some of the books I've read, and you may recall some of these from my February wrap-up and the TBR pile. First up is Gathering of Evil by Gale Valley. This is a book I will be reviewing shortly. It is an extreme horror book, and I may say that the extremity only takes place near the very end of the book, which, you know, I prefer something to be what it is throughout. You know, I wanted something really, really gruesome, but it's a creeping kind of tense horror or thriller to begin with, but then it does ramp up into some depravity. So if you're a fan of the American Guinea Pig films or the Guinea Pig films, this might be something up your alley, although it is a far more tame book than I proposed. And it may not be quite into extreme or splatter, but yeah, it gets pretty dark. Another book I read this month was Conspiracies Uncovered by Dr. Lee Mellor, and this is cover-ups, hoaxes, and secret societies. I thoroughly enjoyed this, and it is on the pile for gifting this year. So if you know me and you have a birthday or something this year, you'll probably get a copy of this. Now, there is a chapter in here on the pandemic, which is very interesting and go-to reading, aside from the fact that it goes from the beginning of a lot of the conspiracies, and it starts out with a chapter called Them. We've all referred to them once in our lives, I'm sure, if not every day, depending on how conspiracy-minded you are, and that goes right into the final chapter. I mean, it is a fantastically laid out book, and I can't wait to talk more about that and How to Behave Like a Human Being. Very, very important reading for someone of my ilk. Now, this was just a little skim tome. If you were thinking of picking it up, I think that it would fit well as like a stocking stuffer. I wouldn't necessarily call it a joke book, in that it is a joke that you have purchased it or gifted it to somebody, but it would fit in that depending on who you're buying it for. So it is very tongue-in-cheek, and it gets a little bit non-PC, as you may imagine. So yeah, it's just a little slim volume. It was fun, interesting reading over breakfast cereal. I don't eat breakfast cereal. I'm trying to behave like a human being. How am I doing? I'd also read, of course, Daughters of Darkness, if you've watched my review on that, and Let's Go Play at the Addams. That was a really fun review to do, albeit very dark. So if you're looking for something a little lighter fare, you can back up and watch my review on Daughters of Darkness. Something a little darker still than Let's Go Play at the Addams. And coming up soon, I'll have another true crime. If you'd seen my poll on my community tab, thank you so much for voting. There was a lot of votes. It was really cool to see that feedback, because who I thought would win didn't. I'll be reviewing the book that I read previous month, which is Defending a Monster by Sam Amarante, and that is about John Wayne Gacy. Who lost out, you ask, if you hadn't seen the poll, was Black Dahlia as a topic generally, because I've read Severed on Black Dahlia, and there's another book coming up that I had neglected to haul earlier that I received and will be reading this month as well. So on to what I'm reading this coming month. So I've talked about it before, and it ties into the Israel Keyes stuff. I'm going to read Dean Koontz Intensity, so that is on the list. Black Dahlia Red Rose by Pugh Eatwell. This goes along with my true crime reading, so eventually maybe I will be doing some Black Dahlia video stuff about some of the books on the Black Dahlia case, because I don't really want to tackle just one book because there are so many, and it's also just a pet project of mine. I do really enjoy this. It goes hand in hand with the Murder Was the Case episodes on Black Dahlia that they're doing, basically one a month for this entire year. And it's not just Black Dahlia, it's related murders too. And 12 Nights at Rotherhouse by J.W. Ocker. This comes with rave reviews. So many people that I watch and cherish, call friends, and really believe the tastes of are really similar to mine when it comes to stuff like this, have said good things about it, so I'm definitely looking forward to reading this. And shiny new, hot off the press, or like hot off the Amazon truck, is Last Book on the Left by Marcus Parks, Henry Zebrowski, and Ben Kissel. And I do listen to a lot of true crime podcasts. This one, as I've mentioned before, is not for the faint of heart, because they do get rather dark, but they're funny too. So if you can't handle some funny with your true crime, then I don't know. But hey, I love it. So this is a beautiful book. I'm looking so forward to talking about it. It's about some cases that we already know. When I get into showing a little more close-ups of this, you'll be able to recognize some of these really cool illustrations. For taste's sake, I won't be able to show too many of them, and I highly suggest picking this up because it is just a beautifully wrought book, and it is just chock full of cool tidbits on all our least favorite serial killers. Stories of murder and mayhem from history's most notorious serial killers. A few books that I don't have physical copies of that I'll be reading is Shadowy Natures by Rebecca Rowland. I'm really late in getting to this one for review, so I'll be watching that. And Punishment by Hope by Eric Hofstatter. That will be upcoming, probably in the middle of the month. I've also got a copy of Hellmouth by S. Alessandro Martinez, and I'm really looking forward to that. Probably in the next month's wrap-up, if I don't receive them sooner, I'll be reading Whisper Down the Lane by Clay McLeod Chapman, and Rave by Con Lavery. So those are two books that I'm waiting on. And there is another one, I believe. Hi there, editing Lydia here, just to interject that the book that I couldn't remember was For Rye by Gavin Gardner. I mean, how could I forget? And I'll be getting a paper copy of that too. So there are quite a few things that I'm still waiting on right now. So you'll see them in the next month's video if you don't see the reviews on those books before then. So if there is anything that you think I ought to be reading, definitely let me know in the comments below. Before I go, huge appreciative shout out to Merce at Harpies in the Trees. Definitely check out her latest video trailer. It's a book trailer for the upcoming Darcy Coates novel. She did a fantastic job. At one point, when I was helping write with Dreadful Tales, I wanted to do book trailer reviews. And maybe I will start doing that again sometime. 5 stars, rave reviews for the Darcy Coates trailer that has just hit, of course. But I mean, I had reviewed some of Aaron Dry's work, and he did some fantastic trailers for his work. So yeah, I'm glad to see a little more resurgence, and I'm glad to see authors reaching out to people who are very good at digital manipulation and doing the audio visual, the entire package that you know Harpies in the Trees is. So yeah, definitely go check that out if you haven't already. I'll put a card up here so that you can see that. And of course, my husband's latest release, Ocean, is now out. You may have seen the little video trailer that he's put up that I helped create. And of course, it's getting really good reception. So congratulations, Chris, and definitely check it out at anorex.com. Thanks again for watching, and make sure that you have an ooky, spooky day.